Hello friends, this lecture is in continuation with your lecture series of tractors and heavy earth moving machinery. This lecture is to be taken on 1st April near lecture timing 10 to 11. This is the content for today's lecture, the types of cranes and choosing a crane. How do you select a crane? Actually, we have started this topic in the previous lecture, but the types are more than the time was less, so I decided to complete all of the types in this lecture. And we'll also decide that if you have a company or if you have an industry, then how do you select a crane. So these are the two major topics of today's discussion. So if I just go through the previous lecture, so these were the five types of cranes. I told you also that according to the application, there are a number of cranes are available, but basically these five cranes are widely used in the industry or on the construction sites. So there are five main. There are truck mounted, rough terrain, crawler, floating and tower cranes. So if I just go through all of these types, so the first one that we discuss is the truck mounted. As I told you, this is very simple in construction. There's only one engine which is used to drive the truck as well as the crane. The hydraulic systems are provided to lift up the crane. Secondly, it is very easy to move from one place to second place. Transportation is very easy, but the disadvantage is it can use for the lesser or less heavier part to be carried away. So this is truck mounted. Then more efficient in terms of carrying the load, the rough terrain, as well as it can take the more load as compared to your truck mounted, but it also has a advantage that it can work in any kind of rough surfaces like mountains or hilly areas. You can use this kind of rough terrain crane. Secondly, it is a four wheel drive and four wheel steering. You might have seen the four wheel drive, all the four wheels are working, four wheel steering, that all the four wheels can turn at one time, and it makes it easier to move on a small or short places distances. Secondly, their movement speed is very less. The transportation speed of a crane is less compared to your truck mounted. Then third, we discuss about the crawler train. As discussed, it does not have any sinking capability. It has a more traction. It can carry more load comparatively all before two cranes. But the disadvantage is the transportation of this crane is very difficult. We need a truck to carry away this crane to the place where it has to be used. Secondly, it cannot move the part to a longer distances. If it carries some weight, it cannot move to a longer distances. So this is a crawler. And next one is the floating crane. You might have not seen this kind of a cranes because we are not living near to the sea areas or the huge watery canals. But yeah, it is to be used. The main advantage, it is used to make the bridges on the or the ports, it is to be used there. Secondly, it does not have much of the counterweight because it uses the buoyant forces of the water to stabilize the crane. And those which are floating things in the sea or on the water canals, on the waterways, these cranes are to be used. So it can carry 10,000 short tons of the weight. It's much more than that. Secondly, floating can also be used for the salvage of sunken ships, means those ships which has been sunk down, they are used to carry it out onto the surface. These are used for the building port and port construction and the bridges. So these cranes are to be used there. Then after that, we are having a tower crane. Similarly, those friends who are living in bigger cities, there are huge buildings. They have seen these kind of a cranes working along with the bigger building, tall buildings. These has a two advantages, this type of a crane. This crane can stand onto the ground. Secondly, it can also mounted onto the building itself. For a tall building like 200 floors, so this kind of a crane cannot work when it is attached to the base. But this has a advantage that it can be attached to the building side of the building, and further it can move upward. So let's say if you are making 200 floors building, so first 15 floors you can make, then you mount the crane onto the 10th floor, then further 15 floor. So this way you can use this tower crane to make the tall buildings. So these are the generally these are the constructions or the the cranes which are used for the construction. Since the truck mounted crane to the tower crane, these all are used for the constructional sites. Maybe they are used for the industry, but very less. So majorly in the industry we use these kind of a cranes, like the container mobile crane. So you might have seen on the seaports this crane, the first one, the container mobile crane, on the seaports or the dry ports like in Ludhiana, we do have this kind of a container mobile crane, so that it can take the container and place it onto the truck and vice versa. The next one is a multi-purpose mobile crane. These are the cranes which are used in the city for the common purposes, like to tow the cars firstly, secondly to carry out the something, and if some truck is overturned onto the highways. So this kind of a multi-purpose mobile cranes are to be used. These are very lighter, these cannot have the heavier load. Secondly, their movability is more, then their maneuverability is more, so they are used in the city. Then the next is your forklift crane. So you might have very familiar with this forklift crane, you might have seen this in the industry also. So these kind of a forklift cranes are used. They are having less power to carry the more load, but yes, these are to be used. Then there are the fixed loader crane onto the garages, onto the waste collection places. These fixed loader cranes are to be used, or in the industry to fill the your boilers or maybe your distillation processes through this fixed loader crane can be very easily done. Next is, which is more important, that is choosing a crane when you are making an industry or you are doing, you have started your construction business. Is it necessary to choose a crane? If it is necessary to choose a crane, then how do you consider it? How, what factors you will consider before purchasing a crane? So first point, he says that identify cranes most suitable to the workplace. So whether you want tall, whether you want truck mounted, whether you want crawler cranes, so what kind of a workplace is there and how you will select it. Then take into consideration the complete life cycle of a crane. What is the important in this? Whether you want the crane for a 1 year or a 2 year, maybe for the full life of it. So if you want it full time, it is necessary to do that, then you need to find out what is the life cycle of a crane, that what is the how much time it can run completely reliable is there. Then third point, which is again an important point, is a maximum load a crane can bear. According to your application, according to the maximum load that you want to bear, so you need to select one. Then next is your safe access point. What is a safe access point? How you can reach to the different part of a crane easily, like the ladders, the footholds, steps and grab rails, so through which you can grab and move up onto the crane for any kind of a maintenance. Then the next one is the seat design, comfort and back support. Like for a driver who's driving the crane, there are multiple controls in the cabin, so it is very much required that he should be at a comfort place. Secondly, his back should be supported because it has to carry, there are a lot of heavy work, psychologically and physically tiring, so it has to be comfort. Comfort is must for the driver inside the cabin. Next is visibility. Visibility through your mirror, through your window or windscreen design, so that it can have a maximum visibility to the periphery of your crane, so that it should not, there should not be any kind of mishappening. Then the environmental control. In India, we do not have these kind of environmental controls are provided inside the canopy or inside the cabin of a driver. But yes, in the abroad, they might have, there are the cranes in which the temperature control is provided for just to work in a excess heat or excess winter. So this kind of a controls must be there. You need to choose it. So this is all about for today's lecture. And if you wanted to check my other videos, you can subscribe my channel Tiny Step. Any kind of previous videos are available, and further videos I'll put onto this channel.